In its July update to the World Economic Outlook, the International Monetary Fund downgraded India's 2021-22 growth to 9.5% from its April projection of 12.5%. The main reason for the downgrade was the severe second wave of COVID-19 infections in the country. Geeta Gopinath, the IMF chief economist, said that a third wave could further damage India's growth prospects. To be sure, there is still a lot of time left for this fiscal year to end. And if there is one thing which the pandemic has done to economic forecasts, it is that long-term pandemics have never been less reliable. Here are four questions rooted in economic data to be released in August which will shape the economic narrative going forward. The pandemic has moved economy tracking from a quarterly affair to a monthly, even weekly affair. One of the most popular post-pandemic indicators has been the Nomura India Business Resumption Index. A NIBRI value of 100 refers to pre-pandemic levels of economic activity. After falling to 45.4 on May 3, 2020, NIBRI gradually recovered to 99.3 in the week ending February 23, 2021. It started falling gradually thereafter, reaching 94.6 in the week ending March 28. As infections surged in April, it fell even more sharply. It reached 75.9 in the week ending April 25 and then to 60.3 in the week ending March 23. The second wave of COVID-19 infections peaked on May 9 in terms of 7-day average of daily new cases. Unlike during the first wave, NIBRI has seen a V-shaped recovery after the second wave to reach 96.4 in the week ending July 18. There was a marginal fall in NIBRI value in the week ending July 25 when it was at 95.3.